Okay, guys, welcome back to JT Reacts. Today we're going to talk about just how dangerous Uber driving is, or can be, depending on where you're at. So let's start off with this one right here.
Dashboard video shows the moment an Uber driver was shot at while picking up a woman in Chicago.
Yeah. Go, go, go. You're gonna shoot up the car.
Shoot up the car?
Yeah, go.
What the f? What is that?
Go.
Yeah, this video is now going.
You can imagine picking up a rider and then having three gunshots shot at you from behind. Sure, there's some areas in Greenville. I'm in Greenville, South Carolina. If you're new to the channel, thanks for hanging out. That I just don't really want to go to. I won't go there if I don't have to, just because it's something like this might happen. Probably not as prevalent as Chicago, but there are parts even out here in Greenville, South Carolina. There's parts everywhere. But he looks like he's hitting some speed bumps pretty hard there too, messing up suspension. If you're wondering, I've been Ubering for almost 10 years on and off. I haven't been doing it about a year and a half. Just started again because my other job, trucking, is not doing so great. But this is what I use, the 2012 Toyota Sienna with red wheels. Oh yeah, and right now we are in the Uber waiting lot for the airport. I figured that'd be a good spot to do this video, but let's watch a little bit more.
Viral on social media, this poor driver, he says the woman contacted police while he pulled over not too far from the scene, but then more gunshots were fired. He says he felt unsafe and told her he couldn't wait for police any longer. They changed their destination and the.
I'd say he felt unsafe, changed destination and it took her somewhere else, but I probably would have stopped the ride right there, just got her safely away from that area and said, that's enough. But yeah, if you're getting someone shooting gunshots at you, I don't know what else is going on, you know?
Woman was dropped off at a nearby relative's house. Still not clear what led to the shooting, but it happened in one of Chicago's most violent neighborhoods.
How many are?
Okay, so you deal with this a lot. I dealt with this a lot in Scottsdale, Arizona. That's where I Ubered a lot before I moved out to Greenville. Got probably 8,000 rides out there. The bar scene out there was pretty crazy, but they would try pack like this guy.
Are you?
Four, I believe.
If it's more than four, I cannot take you. No, thank you.
We're fine.
The girl in the front just said, we're fine, while she's chowing down a taco in his car. Another no-no for Uber drivers. If you guys are Uber drivers, you know all too well what I'm talking about. Just the kind of the disrespect, like you're just there for them. Like, hey, I'm trying to do my job too. Trying to get you guys home safe. Respect the rules. So he only has, probably looks like he has a four-door sedan. My Uber XL, this thing can hold seven, so sometimes people will do that, and they'll just say, and sometimes they'll say, hey, I'll give you extra money, but for five, for that, he's doing some illegal stuff if he takes them, so he's trying to protect his life.
No, it's fine.
You're talking about one extra 50-pound girl.
No, I can't do that.
Come on.
No.
We're fine.
What does it matter how much the girl weighs? One extra 50-pound girl. If there's a 50-pound girl right there, she's probably a midget. But if it was, she was a 300-pound girl, that wouldn't be okay, but 50 pounds is okay. It's funny the logic of people, especially after they've been drinking. I know I bartended for 12 years also. Seen all kinds of logic that didn't really make any sense in the real world.
No.
We're not. I weigh 80 pounds, I promise.
No.
I just got
no,
it.
No, I can't. I cannot do that.
Yeah,
I cannot do that.
Right now.
Okay, but
I already
why?
Canceled it.
Why?
Try to call anyone, please.
I'm confused. Why can you not do that?
Because if I get a ticket, or if I have an accident, I go to jail, and I have three kids. I cannot go to jail for shit like that.
Guess what? I'm a lawyer. I know you won't go to jail for that.
I'm a lawyer. I know you won't go to jail for that. Everyone has a new profession also when they've been drinking. But it's true. He just, it's his butt, not theirs. If he gets pulled over, it's the driver's fault, or the driver's at fault, not the passenger. So yeah, you'll deal with this sometimes in these high bar areas.
You want us to get out?
Yeah, I mean, I already canceled it.
That's...
Oh, okay. So you won't even like let us?
Yeah, I already canceled it.
All right, okay, sorry.
Okay, now this next one. So at least they finally realized they had to get out of the car. But this next one, I don't know what this girl, if she was on something or that guy reminded her of her next boyfriend, but I don't know what I would do in this situation. This poor guy's strapped into the seatbelt and he's trying to get away. Look at this.
What?
Jennifer Gilbo riding in Shoel Mahmoud's car when out of nowhere she appears to snap, lunging at the Uber driver, dousing him with pepper spray.
And like continuing to spray. Like, what are you doing? What was he doing? He didn't say a word to you. Watch the girl, her friend's reaction.
Spray. Shoel picked up Jennifer and her friend on West 46th Street, but when they got to 65th and Lex, things quickly went south early Wednesday morning. The other passenger appears just as stunned.
Jen, what?
Repeatedly asking her friend why she was doing this, Jennifer would only say,
get him out.
What? Get him out. Police did.
So being out here as an Uber driver, you could have some, I mean, that doesn't look like a harsh area or anything like that. Just some girls coming off of a night out with each other. But what the heck? Like, you have to be on your toes all the time. So I did get a new dash camera in here that is recording the passengers all the time, which is very, I guess, beneficial in mind, like these guys have right here. You kind of need that. So I guess she did go to jail for it, though.
Arrest Jennifer. She's charged with assault and now has a lawyer who at this point is not commenting.
Okay, another one. This gentleman seems to be speaking Spanish, but he seems to be very angry at another situation. And he doesn't know this driver, but look what he's doing to him. Like, I don't know what I would do, but I do know what I would do in this situation because I had something like this happen in Phoenix also when I was Uber driving. Early evening, not even late night, but this gentleman that I picked up was pretty intoxicated, as it seems this guy is. And he's like mid-driving and he's trying to open his door and just jump out. Was his... obviously something else is going on there, but what the heck? Are you just going to try and jump out of the car while we're going after you try to hit me like five times? So, that's what happened to me in Phoenix. I had two guys. One guy ordered the ride, and he left. He went somewhere else, like his hotel, and his buddy was going somewhere else, like his house. And right after I dropped the guy who ordered the ride off, he said, hey, take him to the next stop. I'll tip you extra. It wasn't that far, but this is before Uber had like multiple stops for the app, so you kind of got this a lot where people would just like extort you and try to make you take them other places. But he starts punching inside of my windshield. He's like, hey, what are we gonna do? Where are we going? Let's go to the gents club, let's do this now. I'm like, no, I'm just taking you home, man. And starts getting all mad at me, like staring at me without saying anything. I'm like, and he's sitting in the front seat now. He got up from the back and sat in the front like he planned this. And he starts just punching my windshield from the inside. And this is back when I had a 2011 Toyota Corolla. It was actually my wife's car, and that's where we first started Ubering. And I was like, what are you doing, man? So I told him, you need to get out of the car, like out of your car right now. And put it in park, took the keys out of it, walked around, and had to pull him out of the car and toss him onto the ground. It was a grassed area, like a little sidewalk. And then said, hey, man, that's it, man. And then I left a nice bad rating for the guy who ordered the ride and just kind of put a note of what happened. But like, people just disrespect. I know it's sometimes alcohol induced, a lot of these people that have been drinking all day, but man, it's crazy. And then this guy right here, this is when it starts getting real scary. I don't know what part of town this is in. I don't know where this took place, but this is real scary.
The driver's world is instantly shattered as the weapon strikes the back of their head, sending waves of pain coursing through their body. The driver, consumed by shock and fear, is trapped in a nightmarish reality with no apparent way out.
You got it? No, it's under your seat.
Like, what is your course of action there? I mean, this seems a lot of this stuff when they're pulling QPO stuff, it seems like it's the mask mandate era time of life. I guess they thought they wouldn't be identified. Maybe they had different names on their accounts. But then this right here, this is a sneaky move right here. And I want to know. Pay attention to what happens.
It's my seat.
Under your seat.
No, I didn't.
It's a card.
We're going to find it, man. Don't.
The passenger, in a moment of distraction, claimed that he had dropped something in the back seat of the taxi. Requesting a quick stop, they both hoped to retrieve the lost item and continue their...
Did you see when he stopped and opened his door, he quickly looked in his middle console?
...the journey without incident. But as they pulled over to the side of the road, what was meant to be a simple search turned into a startling revelation.
Right here. You got it?
No.
You see?
No. You seen it?
Oh, I got it.
You got it?
The passenger.
So what did he take? Like an old burn CD? Like, remember when he used to burn CDs off Napster back in the day? Did it all the time. Did it for all my friends in college. I had a CD burner and a pretty big catalog of Napster songs. I know people got in trouble for that, but I was just making it for my friends. I wasn't trying to sell them to anybody. I think some of my friends out there still have a couple of those CDs. If you do, awesome. I have a couple also. But I don't know. That's what it looked like he stole. It was like a burnt CD. I don't know. What's he taking? But it's tricky. He makes the guy get out of the car. So when he's distracted trying to help him and open it up the door to look under the seat, he's taking stuff from his middle console.
Ranger hurriedly left, leaving the taxi driver momentarily confused and relieved. Only when the dust settles does this taxi driver realize something unsettling.
So yeah, you gotta take it from then. This is not mass mandate, but this rider seems to be very mad. I don't know if this driver didn't drop him off in the right spot or what happened, but just very unsafe.
What's up? Dude! I'm trying to get out of here. Can you please get out of my car?
Gets hit in the face from somebody outside. Then the guy in the back's hitting him in the face. Like, what did this guy do? Why are they so mad? Because he wouldn't take them where they wanted to go? Wouldn't put extra people in the car? Maybe they were trying to take his car? I don't know. But geez, it's a hot one today too, guys. 82 out here, and it's Greenville, South Carolina, but that's just scary. And then the guy has another one of the PEWs just sitting right there. Like, I don't know. Sometimes it can be dangerous out here. I've never encountered nothing like this out here in Greenville, South Carolina, but I feel for other drivers, and let me know in the comments if you've had anything like this happen while you're Ubering.
Hey, how are you today?
This is crazy, guys. I've never even heard about this till I saw this TikTok, but this poor lady is no longer with us.
Prosecutors played what could be their most compelling evidence against Calvin Crewe. 20 minutes of dash cam footage from Christy Spacuzza's Uber, showing the last moments her family will see her alive. Police say this is Calvin Crewe getting into the back seat of Spacuzza's Uber. His hood is up and he's wearing an all-black face mask that covers all but his glowing eyes. He sits still, only muttering a word or two. 10 minutes into the ride, Spacuzza cheerfully asks,
"Did you have a good day today?"
He mumbles, and Spacuzza says, "That's good." 18 minutes into the ride, police say Crewe inches to the middle of the back seat and then pulls out a gun, grabs Spacuzza's ponytail.
18 minutes into the ride, just getting him where he needs to go.
And presses the pistol to the back of her head.
"What are you doing?
This is a gun. Keep driving."
"No, it's not. Stop. Come on, man. I got a family. What are you doing?"
"I got a family too. Now drive."
"What are you doing?
Drive.
Please stop.
Drive the car, miss.
I have four kids. What are you doing?"
"Drive the car."
So it ended up being what happened is they took, made her get into her phone and like go into all of her apps for like her financials and stuff and transfer money to them and all kinds of stuff. And then they actually took the car. Like, but she's no longer with this guy. It's very sad. And she had three kids. So T's and P's for her. I couldn't imagine. That is just crazy. And here's another one.
"I want to bust your windows and stuff. Like,
she's
really threatening
to bust my window
alone.
Oh my God."
So she is disgruntled again around something. Maybe he didn't drop her off in the right spot or didn't continue the ride or she put in the wrong information where she wanted to go or I don't know what the problem is with the ride, but he's obviously done with it and stopping it. And she gets out and smashes his back window. Crazy, guys.
"I need help."
My goodness. Just be careful out here. This is the last one right here. We'll end it on this. This is not funny, but it's also kind of both their fault, I would say, because I always, if I stop anywhere, I say, "Hey, there's no one behind us or there's no traffic coming up, you're good." But also my door's open, except for the passenger door. It opens like a van would. So, but yeah, guys, just be careful out there. I hope you're enjoying these reaction videos. I'm just kind of pertaining to what I'm doing now. I'm a truck driver by trade, but trucking is not in the cards right now. So I'm out here, we'll be driving with the rest of these guys. It's warm. I want to bring these videos to you guys. I think they're fun to do. And hopefully the microphone's picking up good because it's the first time using this thing. And I'd love to enjoy doing more of these. Give me options for topics you'd like to hear. Check it out in the comments. But we'll end it on this. Not funny, but could have been avoided.
"Yo, it's your nose, bro."
Dashboard video
show. You should have looked, bro. Oh, my goodness. That'll end it, guys. He's done for the night with that one. His door's probably pushed the other way. And his window's shattered, so that's unfortunate. But, yeah, going to get out here, Uber, guys. I hope to see you out here in Greenville. If you're flying in, maybe I'll pick you up one day. But appreciate you stepping in with me, and we'll see you on the next one.